Welcome back to Engineering Simplified. In today's video, we are going to be talking about forward kinematics. What is the forward kinematics of a robot? So it is basically when you are given the robot parameters. So if it is a robot consisting of revolute joints, so you are given the angles of the revolute joints. So you are given the robot parameters and you need to find the end effector's location. And oftentimes its orientation as well. So you go from the robot parameters to the end effector's location and orientation. That is what forward kinematics is. So let me explain this with the help of an example. So here I have an RPR robot. So there is a revolute joint. There is a prismatic joint here. Let me draw it out. So there is a prismatic joint here, there is a revolute joint here, and there is a revolute joint here. So it is called an RPR robot. So here I have marked out the rotations and the extension length. So theta 1 is the rotation caused by the first revolute joint, L2 is the prismatic joint's extension, and theta 2 is the rotation caused by the second revolute joint, right? So what the forward kinematics would involve is you are given these three terms, theta 1, L2 and theta 2, their exact values, and you need to figure out the location of the end effector and its orientation. Now, when we are talking about the location and orientation of something, we need to express it with respect to some reference frame, right? And that is the fixed reference frame. And most of the times we express the fixed reference frame, which is fixed at the base of the robot. So I have drawn this fixed reference frame at the base of the robot, and I have drawn the end effector frame at the end effector right here. So this end effector frame is what is my moving frame, and this is my fixed frame. So I can call this F, and then this is my moving frame. I can just call this M. And you notice that I have drawn another moving frame right here. So this is another moving frame. We will get to why I have drawn this in a second. So if I need to do the forward kinematics, I need to express the end effector frame with respect to the fixed frame. So I need to find out the homogeneous transformation that takes the fixed frame and expresses the moving frame with respect to the fixed frame. So it takes the fixed frame and takes it to the moving end effector frame. So I want this homogeneous transform. And we talked about it in the previous video that in order to get this homogeneous transformation, what we can do is we can take an alternate route, and instead of doing this, we can take this fixed frame and at first take this homogeneous transformation H1 and take this and find out this homogeneous transformation H2, and my homogeneous transformation H would simply be H1 times H2, right? So that is the reason why I have drawn this moving reference frame. So let me just erase all of this. Yeah. So now I have just drawn H1 and H2, my two homogeneous transformations, and I have also marked out this length L1. And if you have a robot in front of you with the fixed geometry, so you would already know what L1 is. And you need to find out H1 and H2, and you would just multiply them together to find the homogeneous transformation that takes the fixed frame and moves it to the end effector frame. So let us dive a little into what the H1 and H2 are. So we know for a fact that H1 and H2 are both homogeneous transformations, and a homogeneous transformation matrix is a matrix that contains two things. The first is a rotation matrix, and the second thing is a displacement vector, right? So the H1 homogeneous transformation is a displacement along Z by L1, which you can see. So H1 is a displacement along Z by L1, right? Once you do that, and then due to this theta 1, it is a rotation about Z by theta 1. So H1 encompasses two things. The first being a displacement along Z by L1, and the second being a rotation about Z by theta 1. I hope you can see how I am getting these. And the second x2 is similarly a displacement about y by theta 2, which is this. And then due to this theta 2, So x2 is a displacement about along y by L2, and it is a rotation about y by theta 2. So this is my h1 and h2. And once I multiply the two together, h1 and h2, I get another homogeneous transform h, which takes my fixed frame to the end effector frame. So it h takes my fixed frame to the end effector frame, and that is what we want. Now let me just expand it out. So h is equal to h1 times h2, and from the previous videos we know that h1 and h2 would contain a rotation matrix and a displacement vector. And if you recall, the last term of homogeneous transform had three zeros and a one. So there were three zeros here and a one here, and then there was a rotation matrix and a displacement vector, right? So for h1, the way h1 is going to be constructed is it is going to have this row, which is three zeros and a one, and then it has this matrix, this vector, which is the displacement vector d, which you see has 0 displacement in x, 0 displacement in y, and L1 displacement in z. And then it has a 3 cross 3, so this is 3 cross 3 rotation matrix, which is the rotation about the z axis by theta 1. And similarly, I can construct h2, which is going to be a displacement along z by L2 and a rotation about y by theta 2. And we already know what the rotation matrices along each of the axes are, and I talked about this in my previous video on rotation matrices, so I'm just going to write them out, and if I write them out, I get this. So I have these two matrices, and once I multiply them out, I get one single homogeneous transform which expresses the end effector frame with respect to the fixed frame. So there are two ways to talk about this. So this homogeneous transformation, what it does is, I can say that it expresses the end effector frame with respect to the fixed frame, or I can similarly say that it takes the fixed frame and moves it to the end effector frame. Both things are similar and just one and the same thing, right? So there are two ways to talk about it. The first is, this homogeneous transform expresses the end effector frame with respect to the fixed frame, and the other way to talk about it is, it takes the fixed frame and moves it to the end effector frame. Now when we're doing the forward kinematics, which what we are doing, we were interested in finding the location and the orientation of the end effector. So from this, how do we extract the location of the end effector? Now if we recall, the homogeneous transformation matrix is always of the form, and once I have this homogeneous transform, what do you think this displacement vector would represent, the three terms here? So this is going to represent the location of the origin of the moving frame with respect to the fixed frame, right? So what this displacement vector would represent is going to be this point right here, the origin of the moving frame with respect to the fixed frame. And that is actually the location of the end effector, right? So that is what we want. So we are really after this. So one way to find out the location of the end effector is simply, you find out the homogeneous transformation matrix, which takes the fixed frame to the end effector frame, and just have a look at it, and you express the and you extract the displacement vector from it. So what I did was, I did not want to do the multiplication manually, so I used MATLAB and I got this. So when I multiplied them out, I got this. And here you can see that it has got three zeros and a one, the bottom row, and the last column has this displacement vector. And what this does is it expresses the end effector's moving frame origin with respect to the fixed frame. Now, there is a more systematic way to get to this same thing, and the way is, let's say if I draw this robot again, which is the same thing, and what I want to do is I want to use this equation that we talked about last time, big X equals to H times X, where the small x is a point expressed in the end effector frame, big X is the point expressed in the fixed frame, as marked here, right? Now, if I need to find out the location of the end effector frame's origin, which is this point right here. So, what would be the small x? Won't this be, since this is small x is expressed in the end effector frame, won't this be just the origin, which is like 0, 0, 0, right? And you should remember that we are talking about homogeneous form, so it would always have a 1 at the end. So if I do this, and if I multiply this by 0, 0, 0, and 1 by the homogeneous transformation matrix, so what I get is a big X, which is basically the location of the end effector frame in the fixed frame, which is going to be identical to this, what we got here. And you should remember that this big X is going to be of the form something, and a 1 at the end, right? And even if you see from this diagram on the left, you can see that our working was correct, because if you see this displacement vector, you can see the Z coordinate being L1, and we can see that the Z coordinate of the end effector is always going to be L1, right? And then you can apply a little bit of your thinking and see that this looks right as well. So that is all that I wanted to cover for this video. And in the next video, we are going to take one numerical example and solve it out and see how everything plays out. And hopefully that will help you to gain a better understanding of forward kinematics. And then we are going to do a video on inverse kinematics and take it from there. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, don't forget to subscribe it. And if you found this content useful, then I would highly appreciate it if you share it amongst your network and friends so that maximum people can take benefit from this. Thank you for watching, and as always, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.